As yesterday we have studied about three states of another two states of matter. Now today we will discuss about the changing of temperature unit.
Changing temperature unit. So in this chapter we just only discuss on only two units, Kelvin and Celsius. So there is a conversion between Kelvin to Celsius and Celsius to Kelvin. So in what is the relation between degree Celsius and degree Kelvin? It is that 0 degree Celsius is equal to 273.15 Kelvin. So there is a formula of conversion, how to convert degree Celsius into degree Celsius and Kelvin. If it is a formula, that is degree Celsius is equal to Kelvin subtracted by 273. So if the temperature is in degree Celsius, we can convert it in if the temperature is in Kelvin, then we can convert in degree Celsius by subtracting 273 from the degree Kelvin value. So for understanding the conversion of Kelvin to degree Celsius and Celsius to Kelvin, we will perform some numericals, practice questions, so that we will understand about it. So first question is, convert into Celsius. So we have given a value 470K. So formula is degree Celsius is equal to K subtracted by 273. So what is the value of K here? It is 270. So I will put this value, just this value, without changing any place of the any quantity. We just put 470 at the place of K. So when we put 470 in this formula, we will get degree C is equal to 470 minus 273. Now when we subtract 273 from 470, the value we will get is 197 degree Celsius. So this is the temperature, this is the value of K which get converted into degree Celsius. Now the next question is, convert into Kelvin. So there are two values which we will convert into Kelvin. First is 30 degree Celsius. Now the formula is degree Celsius is equal to K subtracted by 273. Now we will put this value at the place of degree C. So just put 30 here without disturbing any quantity in the formula. Now we will get 30 equal to K subtracted by 273. Now we will apply the method transposition, in which if we change the place of any quantity, its sign will be changed. Now we have to find out the value of K, so we will bring 273 on the other side. When 273 will bring to the another side, its sign, that is negative, will convert it into positive. Now the value we'll get is 30 plus 273 equal K. Now if we add 30 with 273, we will get the value 30 K. So this is the value of Kelvin unit, which get converted from 30 degrees Celsius to Kelvin. Now, next value is 27 degrees Celsius. So, the formula is degree Celsius is equal to minus 273. Now, put this value here, 27 degrees C is equal to K minus 273. Now, students, as again, I will apply the transposition process. That is, if I bring 273 here, it will become positive, because in transposition, if we change the place of any quantity, the size of the sign of the quantity will also change. Now, 27, 273 with positive sign will be here. 273 is equal to K. Now, if we add 27 with 273, the value which we'll get will be 300 K. So, the value after we get after converting to 27 degrees Celsius, we will get the value 300 Kelvin. This is the conversion of degree Celsius into degree Kelvin.
So, students, here we have completed our chapter Matter in Our Surroundings. We have completed all covering concepts. Now, I have given an assignment, and in that assignment I have given some important questions related to this topic. So you have to solve those questions, and some important definitions also I have given, and any other conceptual questions related to this topic. So here we will over this chapter. Now, tomorrow we will start our next topic. That will be our next chapter 2, is Matter Around Us Pure. In that chapter we will discuss about mixtures, compounds, and the properties of compounds and mixtures, and how to separate the mixtures and compounds, their separate properties, their differentiation, and many other things. Thank you. Have a good day.